Hello everyone, I'm thrilled to have you here with me today. In this video, we're going to do live migration in Proxmox Cluster. But before we dive in, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you never miss any of our content. And if you're a returning viewer, thank you so much for your ongoing support. Your likes, comments, and shares mean the world to me. Let's start. At this time, I am going to create a virtual machine and do live migration for that VM. First, we need to configure disk on Proxmox. Under directory menu, click on create directory. Select your disk, select XFS as a file system, write the name, as you can see, created disk appears here. You can use this disk for ISO image repository and VM or CT disks. Click on Node, from right, top menu, click on Create VM. Select Node, then write the VM name. Next. If you have any ISO after uploaded to the disk, you can see here. But at this time, because I want to show live migration, we don't need any ISO. Next, leave default configuration and click on Next. These are disk configuration. Next, these are CPU configuration. Next, memory configuration. Next, you can configure network interface of this VM from this menu. You can also enable or disable Proxmox built-in firewall from here. Next, finish. Okay, my test virtual machine created. Start this VM. Click on console to check what happened. I want to migrate this VM from server 1 to server 2. These servers have different hardware and CPU. Right-click on VM and select migrate. This is source server, and this is destination server. Sorry, I forgot to create a storage on server 2 host. This is Proxmox installation storage. Click on server 2. Then disks. I have a 299 GB disk here. Click on directory, create directory, select disk and other parameters. Create. Now right-click on Test VM and select Migrate. Created disk on server 2 appears here. Click on Migrate. Because our two servers has different CPU model, we cannot do live migration, but it has solution to do that. shut down this VM? Hard stop from console menu. Stop it again. Finally, this test VM powered off. From a hardware menu, select Process, click on Edit. If you change the CPU type to KVM, you can do live migration from node to any node with different type of physical CPU. Select KVM64. Okay. Now turn on this VM. Select Migrate. Select Destination Disk. Migrate. Migration started. As you can see in the background, our test VM is still on, and if you have any Windows or Linux server without downtime, you can do migration. OK migration finished, and out test VM running on server 2 after migration.
Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you found it informative, and if you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and leave a comment down below sharing your thoughts or any questions you might have. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss out on our future content. And remember, if you enjoyed this video, there's a good chance your friends and family will too, so don't hesitate to share it with them. Sharing is caring.